Now, boy, I got to come up with something to do for demonstration for memoir, and I got to typeset this dumb thing. So we will actually see some real code, real life examples of probably how not to do the thing. A few notes on the presentation. I am merely a memoir user, not a long time one at that, too. I am not the developer. That would be a guy by the name of Peter Wilson. I'm not an expert. So if you ask me detailed questions at the end or in the middle of this, my response will probably be, that beats the shit out of me. So, however, the manual for memoir is extremely good. And that's the first thing that got me into memoir, looking at memoir. And in fact, as an addendum to my talk from the other day, I highly recommend that you get a hold of the memoir manual and take a look at it. The first 50 pages or so are an excellent introduction to basic book design principles. And if you're going to go out and buy the other two books I recommended, get this as well. Obviously, you don't have to buy this. And the source code is available. I retypeset mine in a more pleasing typeface because I too don't like computer modern. Confessions here. I guess we'll have two poison coffees this evening, Steve. So let me just show you this here. But you see, I couldn't resist putting in the hanging numerals and stuff. Yeah, so the first section is called Art and Theory, and then he gives a whole long presentation of various books that he's known and loved, and the positioning on the page, and the dimensions, and the ratios, and the golden ratio, and stuff that will titillate mathematicians who are easily titillated. So. And he does hang out every so often on Comptex Tech. He tends to go on vacation and then he will come back and respond to, 100 messages at a burst and then he'll disappear for a while. But
he's going to have a little piece on memoir in the upcoming issue of the Pragmatic Journal.
Oh, it's probably 10 times better than what I'm going to say here, so since he knows what's going on. So what is memoir? We keep talking about this, and obviously this isn't the thing where I write a story and get on Oprah, and then it turns out that I never was in drug rehab and everything. So, the first thing that we want to step back a little bit, it's been covered earlier today and in the past couple days, is that we don't normally do our authoring in raw tech. We normally use some sort of format. So, either we use plain tech or ePlain or LaTeX or Context or one of the many available ones. So we don't use the engine itself, we use one of these formats. One of the things that LaTeX does that a lot of other formats don't, especially Context doesn't, is it uses packages to extend the basic ideas of LaTeX. So we saw, I think it was in Jim's presentation, sort of a list of 10 packages that everybody should know about and kind of load just automatically. Or, have ready to load automatically. On the other hand, there are nowadays with computers being cheaper and faster and having more memory, even though their video connections still don't work quite right, the need to keep things out is a little bit less than it was before. So there are some people who look for a more monolithic solution, and that's what prompted Hans with Context, where yes, you can load packages into Context, and there are a few that aren't in the core, but as soon as they're vetted and tested, Hans puts them in the core and they're kind of all there at all times. Memoir is a little bit like that. It's not, it doesn't contain all the packages that are available for LaTeX, obviously, but it does contain a lot of them just directly in Memoir. So if you load Memoir, you don't have to load geometry. You don't have to load crop. You don't have to load, a bunch of other packages. But there are some that you do have to load. So if you're going to use color, you have to load the color package. If you're going to use HyperRef, you have to load the HyperRef package. But it usually does work. And so if you want to do this approach, you kind of have to replace the basic LaTeX classes, so book and article and report and letter. There are two major competitors in this space that I know of, ComaScript and Memoir. Is Coma, is that an acronym for something? Do you know?
It's the name of the author, it's Marcus Cole, so it's Coma.
Yeah, okay, but it's always written all caps, so I thought maybe it was, you know. So, that's my entire presentation. So let's actually look at some code and see how a naive user might approach some of this stuff, especially if you've got a week before your presentation and a week before you have to typeset a document that normally you would have done either using geometry and all of these other packages, or you would have done in context. So here we have the first line, I guess I can use the pointer, the document class line using Memoir as the class. And you can pass in a whole bunch of options here. These are just several that I happen to use. So I passed in 10 point, although if I reveal a little bit more, you'll see I actually redefined them, because as I design this document, I have to continually adjust, because I should step back and say this particular series is one that we're under subcontract to Ohio State to produce. But they are an annual lecture in South Slavic linguistics, which I'm sure is dear to certain hearts in here. But the lectures tend to be relatively short. So if we actually want to produce a book out of it as opposed to a handout or pamphlet, we have to make kind of a smallish booklet and make sure that, you know, things work. So I constantly have to tweak the typeface size to get maximum profit out of this. My typeface is Rawlinson, which I have installed per my talk last year, and I have a package for it. I use TIPA because, this being a linguistics thing, actually this particular lecture only uses one symbol that I probably could have gotten elsewhere, but I load it because I know how to do that. And I use GraphicX because I don't like TIPA's symbol for schwa, so I just rotate the box out of a regular E here and adjust the baseline and get my schwa that way. So unlike Stephen, I don't avoid the I embrace it. Joke for the linguist in the crowd. I use French spacing because I like that better. So the next little bit of this deals with the actual page layout and the dimensions and the paper we're going to print on. So set stock size has nothing to do with what you're going to go into and be pilloried later on. That is the thing that you're going to print on. You'll notice here that's 8.5 by 11, that's letter paper. I actually could have passed that up here as an option to the class. It works exactly the same, but I just wanted to show that down here, so I did it that way. So then we have the trimmed size, and that's the size that the book will actually end up. So you see it's kind of a smallish booklet, not too terribly large. Pardon? 7.150 inches. Yes, this is yeah, don't worry about it. This is something that working with the printer worked out to be a nice thing that they've done before. We liked it. It's a series of booklets that some other publisher did, and we thought we'd go with it. You set up the type block size, which will be the actual printed matter within the booklet. We're going to set it up to be 31 lines of type. Notice here we've got stars. The package itself, the class itself, will calculate the other dimensions based on other stuff that's in here. This sets the margins, the outside margins, and this will set the upper and lower margins for us. This mess here, if you read the manual, he goes through in great detail about why you might want to do it this way as opposed to just plugging in values, which you can do. But if you do it this way and you change something at the last minute, it will get properly recalculated, because if you make a change at the last minute, I guarantee you're going to forget to change something in here, and it will look horrible. So if we look at that, and we actually tech this, setting the trim to one half of the trim top and one half the trim edge, by default, Memoir wants to place the document up in the upper left-hand side so that you can actually print these at home and trim them on two sides and get your final document. When you're laying out something and sending it to a printer, they always want it centered. Our particular printer always says, don't give us crop marks or anything, we can do that. The first book we sent through to them, we dutifully removed all the crop marks, and they took my nice layout where I've got it slightly high on the page, which is what a decent book layout should be, and centered everything and ignored all of my design specs. So I yelled at them and said, I'm going to send it through with crop marks this time, and they said, all right, sounds good to us. So let's tech this and see what happens. I'm still working on it, so you're going to find there are tons of overfull boxes and underfull boxes because I haven't finished it yet. But here's what it looks like. And you'll look at it and say, well, that doesn't look very good. The crop marks are going right through the center of the page. And this is where I was the other day. And I tried this, and I tried that, and I tried the other thing. If anybody can figure out what the other thing is and send it to me, let me know. I'd love to have it. And at that point, I was ready to phone Carl and say, I'm not giving my talk. I was mistaken. Memoir's not worth it. Until I discovered, and we'll go through, we'll skip that for now, that Peter has provided this neat little macro called Check and Fix the Layout. Now we'll retypeset it. We still get all our overfull boxes. Ta-da!
Wow.
That
is some macro.
Well, and I, you know... I tried these other macros, and none of them worked.
Can it check back mathematical proofs?
So that's the magic incantation, and he kind of mentions it in passing in the manual, like, and if this is to be used for real, he gives an example. He says, if this is to be used for real, you will want to pass this macro. And what do you mean if it's to be used for real? It doesn't work without it. So, but since this is a good book, we want to have, not the good book, but a good book. We saw the good book earlier.
Yes.
That means that I did something wrong, undoubtedly. No, what it does is it goes through and calculates a bunch of internal factors and spacing and stuff and corrects things that are wrong. So yes, there were things wrong, but it doesn't tell you necessarily what it's done. I haven't parsed the log file.
His whole theory is putting the type block, particularly on the page, in relation to the two-page layout. I mean, I now remember from a couple of years ago, but going back and going through this.
Right. Well, yeah. Right. But those were the numbers that I gave it in the first place. If I had used geometry, it would have done it that way. I already said before that my answer was going to be it beats the shit out of me, so that's my answer will be. So, but since this is a book, we need to have these headers on all the pages that will inform people that this is the Naylor Lecture Series. And for some reason, oh, it's because there's space there. Thank you. Now it will work. And that this is the book by Howard Aronson on Balkan Linguistic League. So normally you would use fancy headers for that, but memoir provides a means to do that by means of a page style. Now, if you go back and look at the memoir manual, as I've recommended, you will note that different chapters in that manual look differently, and he tells you at the beginning of each chapter, this chapter is set with the blah, blah page style, and sometimes it's this particular page style and a particular chapter style. And that is what controls these fancy headers and a few other parameters in there. So we're going to create our own here. Naylor is the lecture series named after a professor from Ohio State. So we're going to look at the even heads and the odd heads, and we're going to put these boxes in there, and that will show us what's in there. I mean, this should be fairly straightforward code. The one thing you will notice in here is that I've played with two different ways of getting the information on there, either by putting it where it ought to be, and there are three different slots there for the left-hand side, the middle, and the right-hand side. You will notice for the odd header, where did I redo this? No, for the even header, I've got the Naylor Lecture Series placed in the center, and then I bump it over to get the fill. The reason why I did that, and I don't know if this is a bug, and if somebody else has used memoir and has seen this, I would appreciate finding out. If I don't put this H space correction in here, even if I put it in the correct left-hand slot, it's moved to the right by essentially 2.5 points. Close to that, but the weird thing is on the odd pages, it does the same thing, but now it's protruding into the margin by that amount. So it's not offset by that.
This is a discrepancy.
Yes, Peter. Sorry. But it should be. I mean, why isn't it? You know, it's. Yeah, I mean, I suspect if we get into the packet, but I would be shocked if this hadn't come up. And I mean, Peter's, if he gets a bug report, it's fixed very quickly. No, there is no space. That's just because I've got this blown up to 36 point. All right, this is it. I mean, I've got it solved, and I'll talk to Peter at some point when he's. Yeah, I just wondered if somebody else who has used, because I know a few other people here use memoir.
I saw this in reference manual also. Ref.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay, so it does happen. So in any case, that is the basic way. We saw this kind of stuff this morning at Peter's talk. That's the basic way to make setups in memoir. And you can do the same thing for chapter styles this way. If you want to change the way the sections are done, you'll do setups in this way. It's very context-like, in fact. So if you are familiar at all with context, you'll be very much at home using memoir. The rest of the document, that's my own thing there. These are just some set links. That's not really memoir. The problem with doing something like this is memoir uses a lot of just regular LaTeX, so that's not really exciting. So here, this is just getting it to use that proper page style. And of course, the first page, I don't want to have the headers on it, so I pass it the plain style. I don't know that there's a lot in here that's actually memoir per se. And then, oh, you're going to say, I'm going to hide that because those are some really ugly hacks that I put in while I was doing this. One other nice thing that I don't have use for in this particular document, but those of us who do write about tech will have wonderful use for. We see here a nice footnote. How many times have you written a document about tech and you want to write a footnote and you want to cite some tech command and you put your verbatim in there and it spits back at you and says, we don't want any verbatim in here. Memoir provides a footnote called verb footnote into which you can place verbatim commands and they will happily tech and you can get on with writing your articles.
Is this compiled with PDF tech?
Yes. Yeah. Other than the one contract that I have that uses memoir that's under NDA because of some stuff that we do with that, that's not PDF tech, but everything else I do is PDF tech.
Is there anything special at the
end? End of what? No, nope, just end document. I don't want to go. And this is, you will, this isn't, you're revealing all of my ugly hacks here. Because this isn't authored in tech, I don't use BibTeX or anything. I just have my own. I mean, I get these from authors, and they've got their bibliography. So I have my own way of doing things.
Why didn't you use Cyril for the Russian
language? This is a South Slavic series, and they do everything in transliteration. So, I mean, other than Bulgarian, all the other languages are in Latin letters anyway, so this is just tradition in South Slavic studies. Right. No, but I mean, if you pick it up in any South Slavic series, it's, I mean, I could do it, but nobody does it that way, so. Yeah, there we go. Well, and clearly, listening to the comments at the conference, everybody now knows not to use Zapfino bullets in your presentation, because those are the two things not to ever do. There were some questions here.
Is it handling periods in some special way? Because, like, for example, J.K. Chambers,
French spacing. Well, that's after a capital, so it wouldn't put the extra spacing there. And I've got French spacing turned on at the beginning, so I never have to worry about that. But no, that's a good question. But yeah, normally after, if you want the sentence spacing and you're not using French spacing, after a capital, you have to put a special symbol in there to get it, to treat it correctly.
I noticed you had a physical break.
Yes.
You have to do that often, and why do you do that as opposed to some other technique?
I normally don't have to do it often. Since this is the first round of my designing this particular book, I've done it to get some things to work. But no, I don't always do it that way. But I do it when it's convenient. I don't.
I mean, avoid the next word.
Yeah, it, Yeah. It was, in this case, it's already a fairly narrow width anyway, and then it's a quotation within that, so it's even more narrow. That's that particular, I think it's not that. Oh, yeah, I could talk about the table. Good thing I paged through here. I didn't want to split it. Tables are done a little bit differently. Here we go. This particular one is done with C tabular, which is part of the class. C tabular is a tabular environment that will happily break over a page. And I had to do it once here. It looks like a regular tabular type thing. You provide your columns with the alignment. And you can do a top rule and a mid rule and a bottom rule. The mid rule is not quite as thick as the other two. So you see here. And I didn't do this as a float, so I just hit that. There's only two tables in the whole thing, so I didn't see any need to go fancy on it. I don't know because I don't use book tabs, so I can't speak to that. All right, any other questions? Those are some linguistic examples. All right, now, if this gets distributed and Peter hears this, and then he'll get upset with me. I mean, I'm quite used to using LaTeX with geometry and crop and all of those, so I'm very proficient in doing that. And this time, of course, I've got to go through the trials and tribulations of running all these examples and then having the thing placed way off and having to solve it, so... Of course, right now it's more difficult for me, but.
What about the result? Do you like it better?
I don't like it better or worse. I mean, I think the result. I mean, it's a good, pleasing tech result. So, because we all know that tech produces beautiful documents. Although we can't tell users that now.